And I give you one story, very shortly, which is enough for us. Among the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there's two stories that we need to think about. One is the story of Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu. And Abu Dharr and his people, Al-Ghifari, Abu Dharr Al-Ghifari, they was the kind of people that when they came into Mecca, everybody was tying down what they had, watching, checking, looking until they left. And no one was saying any words to them for fear that their ignorance would turn upon them, because they were those kinds of people. But I remind you of what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about Abu Dharr. He said, Abu Dharr is a man that walks alone, and he's a man that will die alone, and he's a man that will be raised alone. And Abu Dharr is our example for the zuhud of this dinya, of this deen. One time a man asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, oh Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tell me what to do so that people will love me and Allah will love me. He said, azhad fi dunya, give up your love and your attachment for the dunya, Allah will love you. And give up your love and your attachment for what other people possess, and people will love you. Abu Dharr was the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that represented this hadith. He didn't have any love for the dunya, and he used to admonish the other companions about their involvement in dunya. We mean halal dunya, not haram dunya, but halal dunya. He even used to admonish them about the halal. And the other example is the example of Khalid ibn Walid radiallahu anhu, the man who fought against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the companions, the man who was responsible for the wounding of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the only man who defeated the Muslims while the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was among them, the only man, Khalid ibn Walid. But this is not what we know him as. We know him as this, as what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him, this special title called Saifullah. Because the same saif that he used in dunya, in jahiliyyah, he used it in Islam like no one else used it then or after. A man who, after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu passed away, and Umar ibn Khattab was the Khalifa, he asked Khalid, Khalid, I need you to go to the Persian people, all the Roman people, I'm not sure exactly the battle. How many soldiers you need? Khalid said, give me 500. Umar al-Khattab reminded him, ya Khalid, those people, they have themselves maybe 100,000 troops. Khalid said, okay, then give me 500 more. Umar told him to take 10,000 troops with him. Khalid did not want 10,000 troops. He said, those kuffar, Allah had only given them a piece of the dunya, but Allah gave to us the promise of akhirah. And wallahi, if I went there with the only 10 believers, will come back with their power, will come back with victory. This is how he felt. Because those companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they only cared about the dunya and they only thought about the dunya like the water when it hits the ground in the middle of the sky when in the summertime. How long it lasts? Like that. Like that. Because their hearts was not attached to dunya and they was only thinking, considering akhirah, Allah gave them izzah. Allah gave them power, and that power was felt before they even met the kuffar. And those handful of troops compared to those number of troops which the kuffar had was enough for Khalid. He came back with the victory, mashallah. These are our heroes. And for our young people that are in the streets, we don't like you to be in the streets. We don't like who you are with in the streets. We don't like what you are doing in the streets. We don't like what it does to the image of Islam. But we love you. We love you. You are the sons of Islam and the daughters of Islam and the future of Islam. And inshallah ta'ala, among you, there is an Abu Bakr and there is a Khalid ibn Walid.